I love that. Okay, if you are just getting started with public speaking, the first thing that I want to say to you is, do you have anything to say that anyone wants to hear? Now, lots of people want to be out in front of an audience, but a lot of people don't. You know, that's the number one fear, even before dying, is speaking in front of an audience. So people would rather die than stand up and speak. But those of us who are feeling like we are called to speak, first of all, is soaking in front of the Lord to ask, is this really a message from you? Is this something I'm supposed to say? Are these, do I have something that people even want to hear or need to hear, or that's going to free them, or that's going to help them? Or am I just giving a talk about something so that I can gain from a ticket sale? That's a no-no to me. So first of all, do you have anything to say that you've really been called to say, that you have a hunger to say because it's going to help somebody? So that's the first thing. Then how do you find speaking engagements or gigs? Start talking about the fact that you speak on this particular topic. Now, many people do have a book that accompanies whatever it is that they do. So a lot of this comes in with building your platform. Who is it who you know who will come and do the will hire you to come speak? If you're just getting started, you might have to just speak for free for a while because you just want to get out there. You just want people to know who you are and start to know your name. But after a while, yes, just like royalty publishing is a business, your speaking is a business. Now, unless if you're just called to preach, preach, and you better preach if you're called to do it, right? But you have a message, you feel you're called to do that, you are in business to do that, right? Because just like the preacher at church, a workman working for the Savior, a workman is worthy of his hire. You got to eat. You've got to eat. You've got gas to buy to get back and forth. So treat your speaking like a business. Treat it like a business. There's a fee. Now, if you're not known, you're not going to be able to command the type of fee that someone else can. You'll rise. A C speaker might be just starting. Maybe you don't even have a book yet. You're just thinking about one. You know, a B speaker, maybe your book is published now. More people have heard about you. And then it goes on up right to the A speaker and the A plus. Now, one of these days. but you start off small. You start letting people know. Do things that attract the attention and be current. You should have a blog. You need to have a website. And if you have a blog, again, why are people going to spend their time on your blog? What is it that you have to say? And why do people want it? That's going to be some of your testing ground.